So we have a bunch of diversity. I see red and white clover, had a bit of alfalfa in, orchard grass, ryegrass, and probably festolium. So this pasture was hayed about 50 days ago. So it is fairly old. Seems to work well for the dry cows. We've been able to build organic matter very quickly on a pasture system, quicker than we could on a perennial haying system. Managed grazing is art and science. It's simply rotating cows through pasture, pretty much move cows from one section to another, allow rest on the pastures, which when you rest, they'll be able to grow back. If you just allowed the pasture to be continuously grazed, it'd look like your lawn and it wouldn't be yielding much. When a dry, hot spell would come through, it'd just burn up. Our fences, our perimeter fences are first strain high tensile. We're using temporary wires and geared reels to subdivide paddocks. We have improved walk lanes. We have main lanes and then artery lanes that go up to the side to get to the paddocks. We have inch and a half or inch and a quarter water lines to our paddocks. All cows would have access within 500 feet of a water tub at any part of the pasture. So one of my favorite things to do is to move cows. I'd like to see them walking around that line to the new pasture, and then they put their heads down and start grazing. Today, doing this kind of system, we see a more higher organic matter in the soil, a little bit more diversity, and we have a much healthier cow that breeds back quicker. Yeah, I think, you know, the grazing, because it's a perennial base, when it's rains coming, it soaks it up. When the sun shines, it grows. It's kind of a risk management strategy on my part, where we don't have maybe the high highs of growing corn and the tonnage, the yield that can come from that, but it keeps everything pretty steady, that unless we have a 2-month crazy drought, we should be okay. Farming, especially nowadays, it's a lot more management, a lot more mindset. So I have a full-timer and 2 part-timers helping. My mentor back when we started really committing to grazing said, there's gonna be so many opportunities coming through. And within 3 years, someone from Organic Valley saw our cows out in pasture and stopped in and wondered if we thought about organic. We're certified organic since 2019. The benefit of being certified organic is the price. There seems to be demand, real good demand for organic milk right now. It's a stable market. It's not gonna go up or down. And if it does, there's gonna be meetings that you know it's coming. So it's been really helpful. So we belong to Organic Valley Co-op. They will market our milk. They give us a good price. Very stable. They have people on hand, experts to help with milk quality. They have a vet on hand, nutritionist for the cows on hand. So it's been a real good co-op to be a part of and get to meet other like-minded farmers. So this field was in corn in 2015. Our soil was thin, shaley, well-drained, so it's not the best to grow corn on. So we felt that pasture and grass would just do a better job. The forage is more balanced and we're able to keep our cows full. So for an aspiring grazer, there's all kinds of things you can start with, but the biggest one would be a mentor. I mean, books and the different ag agencies will help you get started, but a mentor is really gonna help you. Even to this day, I find I ask questions on things I don't understand. So it really helps you have confidence in what you're doing. As a mentor in the grazing program, it's good seeing someone be able to gain knowledge and start doing their own thing on their farm and in their grazing. I think on a sustainable farm, you'll see healthy animals grazing pasture with minimal chemical inputs. And the most rewarding thing is just being able to live off the land without having an intense need for farm machinery and fuel. I mean, we still use it. We still want to produce as much as we can in a healthy ecosystem. But yeah, it's nice when you don't need to worry about that next cutting of hay or cornfields as much. Yeah, I feel I'm part of the ecosystem. I mean, I feel you, when you take over land, whenever you're done with it, you should have it better than what it was before. And I can definitely say our land is better than what it was before. Favorite part of the day is at the end of the day when the cows go out, you close off the line, they have their feed, they're happy, they're healthy. You go enjoy your evening and wake up the next morning ready to milk them.